Sugar beet is an important sugar crop in temperate parts of the world. It's adapted to cooler climates, and its claim to fame is concentrating huge amounts of sucrose in the root. That sucrose makes it a very good place for pathogens as well, because they love to feed on that sugar. And so sugar beet is known to have many different types of root disease. That's why wild beets have become very prominent recently. This is a wild sugar beet. This is what sugar beet was domesticated from. And I never think of sugar beet as a vining crop, but look at this thing, sending out these long tendrils. So one difference is the form of the plant. Another is that this is actually going to flower and set seed in this first year of growth, whereas the cultivar is a biennial. It will only produce seed the second year. These wild types have been collected by plant scientists because of the inherent disease resistance. Crosses have been made and resistant varieties developed on the basis of resistance in the wild. So certainly, although this doesn't look like anything that would be economically important per se, it harbors important genes that we need to ensure the crop survivability.